In this video, we will solve a question for Gauss's law in the case of spherical symmetry. It's given that we have two spherical surfaces. First, we have a sphere of radius A, which is completely enclosed within a bigger sphere of radius B. And it's given that all the charge is distributed in a volume in between these spheres, given volume charge density rho as some constant k divided by r square. Therefore, rho is dependent on radius. Therefore, to find the net charge, we will have to integrate rho over the entire region. We are asked to find the electric field in three regions. First, when the radius is less than A. Second, when the radius is in between A and B. And third, when the radius is bigger than B. Let us calculate the electric field for the first case. Let us draw a Gaussian sphere of some radius R, which is less than A. This R is less than A. So we will now solve for the first case when the radius is less than A. Let us first just write the formula for Gauss's law, which is closed surface integral of electric field is equal to the charge enclosed within the sphere divided by epsilon naught. Since we are given volume charge density rho as k divided by r square, we will first find the charge enclosed within the sphere of radius r. But as we can see, the entire charge is distributed in between the spheres, that is, in between the spheres of radius A and radius B, that is, in this region. Therefore, the total charge enclosed within our sphere of radius R is equal to zero. Therefore, the electric field will also be equal to zero. This is the answer for the first case. Now we will find for the second region. When R is in between A and B. We will again write the Gauss's law, which is closed surface integral of E dot dA is equal to the charge enclosed divided by epsilon naught. We can see that the charge enclosed depends on the volume charge density rho, which is given as constant k divided by r square. Therefore, we will first calculate the charge enclosed. It will be volume integral of rho d tau, where d tau is some volume element and rho is the volume charge density. We will do it in spherical polar coordinates. Therefore, rho is given as k divided by r square. And volume element in spherical polar coordinates will be r square sin theta d theta dr d phi, which becomes r square get cancelled. We can take the constant k outside. Integral of sin theta d phi dr. We know that theta goes from 0 to pi and d phi goes from 0 to 2 pi. And in this case, dr goes from A to R. Therefore, we can write this as integral of sin theta is minus cos theta. Therefore, we get k times minus cos of upper limit, which is pi, minus cos of lower limit, which is 0, times 2 pi, times integral of a to r dr becomes r minus a. We can write this as k cos of pi is minus 1. Minus 1 times minus becomes 1. Cos 0 is 1. minus 1 times minus becomes 1, therefore we get 2. 2 times 2 pi becomes 4 pi times r minus a. This is the charge enclosed within the sphere of radius r. Now we will calculate our integral e dot dA. Since we have taken a sphere, a Gaussian sphere, and we know that the electric field has radial dependence, that it depends on the radius, therefore the electric field at any point on the surface of the sphere will have the same value, that is, the electric field will be constant. And since a small area element dA, area vector dA, and electric field point in the same direction, we can get rid of the dot product. We can take the electric field outside and get rid of the dot product. So E becomes integral of dA, which is surface area of a sphere of radius r will be 4 pi r square. Therefore, we can now put everything together. E times 4 pi r square is equal to charge enclosed, which we found as k times 4 pi times r minus a. Divide by epsilon naught. 4 pi, 4 pi cancel. Therefore, we have electric field as k divided by epsilon naught r minus a divided by r square. This is the answer for the second case. Similarly, we will find the answer for the third case, where the radius is bigger than b. Again, we will first write down a Gauss's law in integral form. Charge enclosed divided by epsilon naught. Since we are taking radius bigger than b, we first had our inner radius a, then our outer radius b, and now we will take a Gaussian sphere of radius r. We know that the entire charge is distributed in the region between these two spheres. Therefore, to find the charge enclosed, we will integrate from A to B. We will integrate from A to B, as going from B to R doesn't matter. Since the entire charge is distributed in the volume between the spheres, we will integrate from A to B. Rho d tau, which becomes, since we have already done this integral in the previous case, we will get k times 4 pi, and here we will get b minus a instead of r. This is our charge enclosed. And again, with the same reasoning, we can calculate our integral. E will come outside and we can get rid of the dot product, and the surface area will be 4 pi r square, which will be equal to charge enclosed, which we found as k times 4 pi b minus a, the whole divided by epsilon naught. Therefore, our answer for the third case becomes E is equal to 4π get cancelled. We have K divided by epsilon naught B minus A divided by R square. This is the answer for the third case.